Okay, good evening.
大家晚安.
Hope everybody had a dinner.
希望大家已经吃了晚餐了吧?
That's the regular Chinese greeting.
华人都见子问安了，对吧?
Right? Have you eaten?
每次见面的时候都问吃了没?
Okay, so, amen. Okay. Alright, so just now I had dinner with Derek and Xavier. That was quite fun.
刚才跟
Xavier 还有 Derek 吃晚餐 蛮愉快的过了 Amen. So, alright, so today we're going to continue our series about prayer.
Come on. 今天晚上呢，我们再一次的学习祷告。
I hope that your prayer life has been improving.
我真的希望大家的祷告生命呢也进步了。
Now prayer is, you know, when you think about prayer, it is always something very meaningful.
每次一提到祷告呢，其实对我们来讲都是很有意义的。
You know, because it's something very personal.
因为它可以是非常亲切。
And it really fill up your heart.
然后呢，可以充满你的内心。
Because when you pray, you really get feel the closeness of God.
因为当我们在祷告的时候呢，我们能够感觉到我们亲近神。
And as the scripture says, you know, when we pray, when we cast all our anxiety on God, you know, the peace of God that transcends all understanding guards our heart and mind in Christ Jesus.
就好像在圣经说，他说，当我们在忧虑的时候，把一切忧虑都借给神呢，叫好叫神把他的平安呢，能够借着一切能够赐给我们。
Okay, so, all right, so a few weeks ago, we talked about the prayer from a devoted heart.
两个礼拜前我们学习到就是。 来自一个诚恳的心的那种祷告。
You know, God wants to be devoted to you.
因为神呢，他其实呢，他想要对我们呢，就是有一个有诚意。
He wants to be a devoted friend to you.
他要就是很全心全意的对你。
You imagine that God wants to be a devoted friend to you.
你有想过吗? 神他竟然想要全心全意的做你的朋友。
And in the same way, God wants us to return the same type of devotion.
那么相同的，他也希望呢，我们以着一个相同的那个心来回应他。
And when we are devoted to God, it really moves God's heart.
因为每当我们呢全意的去向神的时候呢，我们可以感动他。
Again, it's just like our relationship with one another. You know, when you have a friend that's very devoted to you, you're more than willing to do things for them.
因为呢，当我就好像我们对彼此一样，我们有一个全心全意对你的朋友的话呢，你们呢，就是有一个好的关系。
So today we're going to talk about another aspect of prayer, the prayer from the heart of thanksgiving and praise.
那么今天呢，我们将会学习另外一种祷告的角度。 那是来自一个存有感谢和赞美的心。
Again, so what is thanksgiving?
到底感谢是什么意思呢？
Alright, thanksgiving is giving thanks to God for what He has done for you.
到底感谢是什么呢？ 感谢就是谢谢神他所为我们做的事。
And praise is a little bit different. It's not the same as thanksgiving. Is expressing our appreciation for the great things that God has done and praising Him for who He is.
可是呢，在赞美呢，却跟感谢有稍微不一样。那就是呢，我们赞美的时候呢，我们是发我们表达出我们欣赏神在这世上所做的一切美好和伟大的事。
You know, when you think about this concept, right? Praising God, thanking God. You know, it seems like a very easy concept.
有时候我们在想说，来感谢或者是赞美呢，很容易嘛，对不对？
You know, we feel like, yes, I need to praise God. That's what worship is about. Yes, I need to give Him thanks. That's what our life is all about.
有时候我们在想说，要给神感谢，要赞美他，根本就是我们生命成为基督徒的意义嘛，对不对？
You know, it's very easy. It's an easy concept to understand, but it's a very hard thing to practice.
可是呢，讲真的，其实是讲的容易，做却很难。
Okay, because you think about it, you know, whenever we pray, how much time do we dedicate to praise and thank God.
就拿我们平时的一般祷告吧，我们花多少时间在我们一个祷告里面呢？去赞美和感谢他，能花多久呢？
Right, think about your morning prayers when you dedicate your prayers to God, your quiet time. How much time do you take to praise and to thank God?
就拿你每天早上向神祷告吧，你其实花多少时间来去感谢和赞美神呢？
You know, for some of us, maybe you do the evening prayer before you sleep, right?You know, how much time really do you take to thank and praise God?
也或者是我们那些比较习惯晚上祷告的，那你又问你自己啊，其实花多少时间感谢和赞美呢？
Most of the time, you find when we pray, when most people pray, they might thank God and praise God for a very short while, and all of a sudden, they start to shift towards their needs.
那你知道的，当跟一般人祷告的时候呢，都会发现他们呢有一个简短的赞美和感谢过后呢，很快的就把全部的焦点都放在他个人的需要上。
Again, they'll start to pray, God, please, tomorrow exam. Wow, you can pray for 1 hour about the exam.
那么呢，你在祷告的时候呢，你就想神啊，你也记得吗？明天我要考试，然后你就可以继续持续这样子祷告一个小时，就是为了你的考试。
Okay, or you have a problem in life, right? You know, when you go to pray, and most of the time you're praying about your problem and very little about thanksgiving prayer. Praise.
那么或者是我们呢面对了一些问题，然后呢你的祷告里面呢就只是充满了你所面对的那些问题，可是很少啊赞美和感谢。
You know, for most people.Again, for most people, not all people, for most people, they usually just give thanksgiving and praise 3 times a day. You know when?
大部分的时候呢，我们一般人一天就是只给3次的感谢啊。你总是什么时候呢？一天3次。
Breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Thank you, God, for the food.
那就是你的早餐、午餐和晚餐，然后你感谢神啊，你赐给我们的食物了。
Okay, that's why this topic is very important. You know, it's an easy concept to understand, but it's a very hard, you know, concept to practice.
所以呢，这是为什么我刚才说，讲起来是很容易了，但是做却很难的。
You might think, why is it hard to practice?
为什么这样难呢？
Because in our society, in our culture, in our life that we've been brought up, most of the time we tend to be what? Very negative.
但是因为呢，来自我们的生活背景，我们的环境呢，造成我们很容易负面。
Right? You will open the news, or you read the news. CNN! How many pages of CNN is good news?
因为当我们就打开来看新闻 CNN 的话呢，其实有多少个是报好消息
？Okay, I don't know what you read yet. What? Today online is it? Oh, you don't even read that. Malaysia Kini. That's what you read. you flip the page. Everything is bad news, criticizing, right?
对啊，你在读新闻的几乎每一页。都在报坏消息的。
Very, very few news is about, wow, I thank this person for doing that. I praise this minister for, you know, I'm not saying, you know, anything about politics, but I praise this person for this. It's very rare, hardly any in the news.
然后呢，你就很少会读到说啊，在报章里面呢、啊，说啊一些感谢这个人，感谢那一件事情，你就很少读到这种所谓的感谢的新闻。
Right, so same thing with us in our culture, because we are brought up in this type of culture, we too tend to be what? Very lacking in praise and gratitude towards God.
那也是因为我们来自这些文化背景呢，造成我们呢就是很难去讲出感谢的话。
Okay, so we're gonna do a Bible study, a lot of scriptures, all right, about the idea of thanksgiving and praise in the Bible.
那今天呢，我们将会读圣经，学习学习如何感谢和赞美。
So let's turn our Bible to Nehemiah chapter 12, verse 46.
那我们来读尼希米记第12章46节。
Okay, here's the time when Nehemiah has rebuilt Jerusalem. Alright, and after he rebuilt Jerusalem, rededicated Jerusalem. You know, let's see what he said about, you know, his rededication. Let's read verse 46.
在第46节这里说, 古时在大卫和亚撒的日子呢, 有唱歌的灵长, 还有并有赞美, 称谢上帝的诗歌。
You know, you read this verse, I forgot to highlight this. For long ago. What does that mean?
其实在圣经上面说,他说在古时,
it means for a long time, huh? They never gave thanks to God, you know.
其实他说,其实在古时,到现在就是他们有一段很长的时间,他们没有去赞美神的。
So in their worship of God for many, many years, they were just praying about their needs and their troubles.
也就是说呢,这些人已经变为就是说,常常他们只顾着自己的需要,向神祈求罢了。
And finally, Nehemiah remembered after rebuilding Jerusalem. He said, Ah, I remember the old days of David. You know, when David was a king, there was so much praise and thanksgiving.
那么李希米他就跟他们说，他说，你知道吗？我就记起来了。那么在很久很久以前，大卫王的那个时代呢，啊，他们常常都这样子来赞美和感谢神。Okay,
so if you have trouble praising and thanking God, you're not alone.
那你今天如果觉得在感谢和赞美上帝是很困难，那么你不孤单。And
just like Nehemiah, we need to really learn how to what, you know, remember that praising and thanking God is so important in our prayers.
所以呢，我们必须要像啊，你心里这样子提醒，被提醒这样子，就是啊，很重要啊，能够去懂得如何向神赞美和感谢。Okay,
let's look at another verse, Psalm 145, verse 1 and 2.
那我们再看诗篇第145章第1到第2节，我的上帝，我的王啊，我要尊崇你，我要永永远远。 称颂你的名，我要天天称颂你，也要永永远远赞美你的名。Okay,
so this is a psalm written by David.
这是大卫所写的诗。
You know, we only read 2 verses over here.
我们呢读了两段经文。
If you read the entire chapter, again, of Psalm 145, it's like his prayer. The entire chapter is just about praising God, you know.
如果是我们把整个诗篇145章读完的话呢，你会发现说整篇都是大卫赞美的祷告。
You know, in 2 lines, again, he uses the word praise or exalt, extol 4 times.
那么短短的两节经文罢了，大卫就已经用上了至少4次来去赞美，他说来用赞美上帝。
You know, no wonder Nehemiah remembered. He said, "Wow, look at David. You know, he was a man of God, and he, you know, and his prayers and his songs were all about praise."
这就不怪了，为什么啊？这个啊，尼希米他记得大卫王如何啊，就是很喜欢赞美和感谢。
So can you imagine your morning quiet time? Okay, your 20 minutes or your 30 minutes quiet time. You know, when you go out, get up to pray, your entire prayer. Is this about praising and thanking God?
你可以想象一下吗？你每天的早上起身过后的祷告呢？几乎一半的时间都在赞美和感谢吗
？Okay, I know that's very difficult for me. All right, just like you and me. Okay, you know my tendency is praise God for a few minutes, and then I think about all my troubles.
你看我其实跟你们其实是很相似的，因为呢祷告了不久，很快就会想到我自己的需要和问题。
Okay, but we need to learn. Okay, we need to learn to really put in this this ingredient. Okay, of praising and thanking God in our prayers.
不管是怎样啊，我们还是得就是学习，就是把这个很重要的元素，就是感谢和赞美呢，放在祷告里面。
You might think, why is that all important? Why do we need to praise and thank God?
那你讲说为什么那么重要啊？赞美和祷告啊，向神赞美和祷告呢
？You know, when you show gratitude to God, it really moves His heart.
那是因为当我们向神 表示我们的感恩的话呢，我们可以感动神的。
Okay, think about what moves your heart in your day-to-day life.
你想一下，你每一天的生活什么东西可以感动你？
You know, in your relationship with people.
当你跟别人的关系上。
Isn't it when people show gratitude towards you?
那是当有人对你感谢感恩的时候，难道不能感动你吗？
Well, I remember when I first started to work many, 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 many moons ago.
那我还记得我在很久很久之前做工的时候。
You know, of course, after graduation, going to work, you know, I was very excited. Yeah, finally, I get to work, you know, to do my dream job.
那么我在开始做第一份工的时候，我就感觉到非常非常的兴奋，我讲哇，我终于可以做工了。
I was an engineer at that time.
在那时候，我是一名工程师。
You know, and as I went, of course, you know, I enjoyed the work, but as I started to work, you know, my dream became to get dashed.
当我在开始体验工作过后呢，后来就受到挫啊，就是面对了就是梦想受到了一些挫折。
Okay, not because I don't like the job, but because of my boss.
那并不是我不喜欢那份工作，而是因为都是老板。
Get every day, get scolded.
每一天几乎都被他责备。
How come this not accurate? Why there is a problem? Aren't you an engineer? Huh? My technician can do better. It's like, wow, goodness.
每天都在骂我，他说为什么你做什么东西都不对的？然后你到底是不是一个工程师来的？我的那个投手都比你更厉害嘞。
After a while, I feel like quitting.
然后过了不久，我就很想辞职了，不干了。
You know, it's no wonder you find a lot of people, right? They keep switching job, you know, because there's no gratitude in the job.
因为这是为什么你发现有很多人他们喜欢就是换工作，因为发现他们不能够被人就是接受感谢他的付出。
You know, even if it's their dream job, after a while they want to resign or they want to find another job.
就算他这是他很喜欢的梦想的那一份工作呢，可是如果是这种情况之下，还是他想要走的。
You know, gratitude is very important.
所以呢，能够感谢是很重要。
Again, I remember after that, again, many years after my first job, you know, I was in the ministry and I worked with the office and administration. Again, I remember working with this particular supervisor.
那么我还记得之后我在全职服侍在教会的时候呢，在特别是在教会的这个行政部里面跟某一个上司在一起做工的时候。
Okay, I was in Singapore, so I did the ministry, but I also help out because I also lead the administration.
那么我就其实在不单单是负责就是教会行政的工作，我其实也有在就是在带领。
So this brother that supervised me, his name is Jim Blau. He's a big American.
那么我还记得，就是这位弟兄名字叫 Jim Blau， 他是一个美国人。
Okay, and he was so different, you know, from all my other supervisors.
那么他这个美国人，他对我是跟我以前的那个上司对我是不一样。
You know, and for the first time, not first time, for for a very long time.You know, because no one ever really thanked me about my work.
那么其实呢，我在这样子做了好一长的一段时间，都没有感觉到有人这样子来感谢我。
You know, and then but with him, every time I do something, he will give me a call. Hey, Tech Ming, thank you for your hard work.
那么他在的时候呢？就是每一次我做完那些事情，他都会打电话跟我说声Tech Ming， 谢谢。
Okay, back then no email. Okay, everything is by phone or what you call fax. Okay, every fax that come in, wow, Tech Ming, I appreciate your hard work.
那么当年呢是没有手机的，所以就是他们就是要不嘛电话，要不嘛就是传真，然后来了都会跟我说Tech Ming， 谢谢你这样子。
You know, after a while, you know, my heart began to be so happy, you know, because here is a guy, my boss, you know, okay, at that time. You know, instead of criticizing, he was what? Very grateful for my job.
那么他呢就跟一般不一样，就是他并没有批评论断，反而是呢他就是充满着每经过每做一样事情都他都感谢我。
You know, I remember even once we went on a trip together. Okay, we all the, our administrators we went to New Delhi. You know, he he didn't pay for it. Okay, he got the company to pay for it. We went to visit the Taj Mahal and all those things.
那么还记得有一次呢，跟就是所有这些行政的人员呢，就是一起去到了印度的 New Delhi， 然后就是他。
Okay, back then, of course, to travel overseas is a bit more expensive, huh?
Even
now expensive, right?
当然，在当年这样子去旅游，其实飞机票很贵。
Okay, so I remember in one of our what we call morning devotional, he got together with all of us, and he said, you know, guys, you know why I organize this retreat for all of you?
那么就有一次早上当大家聚在一起做灵修的时候，他就问我们说，他说你知不知道我为什么要特别这一次就是举办这个这样子的这个退休会呢？
Okay, he says because I want to show my appreciation to all of you for your hard work through the years.
那么他就跟我们说他其实他说他想要趁这一个机会来特别为着那一些付出的那些人呢，去向他们表达感恩。
Wow, when I heard that, I felt like wow, I feel like a king.
当我听到他这么说的时候，我觉得真的很内心里面受到很鼓励，然后觉得好像自己好像做了皇一样。
His appreciation is his few little words of thanksgiving.Okay, towards me and towards all my fellow colleagues. That really moved my heart to want to work even more harder for him.
那么也因着他的这一些感谢的诚恳的感谢呢，使得我得到很多的鼓励，甚至呢让我觉得说我可以为他就是付出。
You know, in fact, he's one of the guys who kind of helped change my life, not by challenging me, okay?Not by pushing me, okay, but by what? Encouraging me. You know, my life literally changed after that.
那么他是其中的一个，就是用着不是一般的，用着是只靠着鼓励感谢呢就几乎就是影响了我的很多生命的很多地方。
So you see, you know, when we receive, just like when I receive thanksgiving and praise from my supervisor, it moves my heart. When you give God thanks.When you praise God, it will really move God's heart as well.
就好像我刚才跟大家形容，我因为别人感谢我呢，而我内心里面受到那种感动一样的。当我们换成是我们向神感谢的时候呢，神的心同样的能够被我们感动。
So you know, we gotta ask ourselves: Do I really thank God? Am I really grateful to Him with my prayers?Do I really show him a lot of, appreciation? Do I praise him a lot in my prayers?
这是为什么我才想说问大家在我们的祷告里面，我们是否有真正的、有诚恳的，能够向神感谢和赞美的意思
？Okay, we're gonna look at some examples over here about the power of thanksgiving and praise.
我们来看看几个有非常有力量的那些祷告那感谢的祷告。
Okay, we're gonna turn the Bible to Luke chapter 17.
我们看看就是路加福音的第十七节十七章。
Okay, we're gonna read here this whole thing and as you read, okay, I want you to really imagine to feel what Jesus is feeling.All right, as he helped the leper.
当我们在读这段经文的时候，我希望大家去真正的去尝试体会就是耶稣当在帮助这个麻风病的那个人的他的那种耶稣的感受到的那种心情。
All right, so let's read.
在路加福音第十七章第十一节到十三节，耶稣往耶路撒冷去，经过撒玛利亚和加利利。进入一个村子，有十个长大麻风的， 迎面而来，远远的站着，告诉说：“耶稣，父子，可怜我们吧。”第十四到第十六节，耶稣看见了，就对他们说：“你们去把身体给祭司啊，给祭司查看。”他们去的时候就洁净了，内中有一个见自己已经好了，就回来大声归荣耀与上帝，又俯伏在耶稣脚前感谢他。这人是撒玛利亚人。然后第十七到第十九节，耶稣说：“洁净了的不是十个人吗？那九个人在哪里呢？除了这个外族人，再没有别人回归荣耀与上帝吗？”就对那人说：“起来走吧，你的信救了你了。”
Okay, so we look over here. Here's an example, alright, to show, you know, how our gratitude or ingratitude move God's heart.
这边呢，就是一个非常好的一个例子呢，就是提到就是我们对神的那一份感恩感谢的心。
You know, so here we see what 10 lepers running up to Jesus. Jesus!Help me! Just like us, right? We always pray. Jesus, help me!
然后你就想象，就是这些十个大麻风的人呢，他们在朝着向耶稣走去的时候，向耶稣大喊说：“耶稣啊，你帮我吧！”就很像我们向神祈求一样，“神啊，你请你帮我啊！”一样。
So you can imagine, the crowd were there, so many people were there, but Jesus stopped just to what hear their plea.
那么你是想象到当时很多的人，然后呢在很多人当中呢，可是耶稣呢竟然停下来。
Okay, and Jesus says, go show yourself to the priest, and you will be healed.
那么耶稣就对他们说，这病人说，你去大祭司面前去，你如果是听的话呢，你将会得医治。
You know, so after they were healed, what happened?
那么他们得医治过后发生什么事情呢？
The Bible says only one of the leper came back to thank Jesus.
那圣经说就只有一个就是得到医治的大麻风病人呢回去感谢耶稣。
You know, you can see how it affects Jesus. Jesus says, well, were not 10 cleansed? How come only one came back?And not only one, he's a foreigner. So good to be a foreigner, is it? Yeah, Singaporean in Malaysia. Okay, so, you know, it really affected Jesus, you know. I wonder how Jesus felt. He must have felt so sad that, my goodness, I helped 10 people and only one came back.
你可以看见当我们读这段经文，耶稣的那种反应是什么？耶稣的反应就是说，他说：“我刚才不是帮了十个吗？为什么只有一个回来感谢呢？”他心情肯定非常的就是失望觉得说为什么只有一个人懂得感谢
？Okay, so you see, your gratitude or your ingratitude affects Jesus's heart.
你看见吗？你们的。感恩的心，或者是不懂得感激的态度呢，都能够去影响耶稣。
You know, Jesus is always willing to help.
当然，耶稣他是很全心全意的，乐意的想要帮。
You know, but our question is this: Are we one of the nine that never came back, or are we the one that comes back to thank Jesus?
可是问我们自己是。我们是那九位不懂得感恩的，还是那唯一的就是懂得感恩的那个病人吗
？Okay, so often, right? We tend to be like the rest of the nine. You know, we ask Jesus, "Help me, God, please." You know, and then when God answers, we forgot about it already. We don't come back to God, and is grateful to us.
很多时候呢，我们就其实很像那九个人一样。我们懂得向神祷告说，神啊，请你帮我吧。可是当神真正的应许了你的祷告过后呢，你却没有真正的去感谢神。
Okay, we need to be the one. We need to be people that are always grateful, always giving thanks, always giving praise to God in our prayers.
那就是为什么我们呢必须要常常提醒自己，应该是一个需要常常向神祷告啊，向神赞美，向神感谢的那个。
You know, when you have a grateful heart, right? It makes you a happier person as well.
其实呢，当我们呢心存有感激和感谢的心的话呢，也会让我们呢比较容易就是很快乐多一点。
Okay, let's look at another example.
那我们再看另外一个例子。
How our gratitude or ingratitude affects Jesus.
也让我们再注意看一下，就是懂得感谢和不懂得感谢的都会影响耶稣。
Luke chapter 7, verse 36 to 50.
在路加福音第七章三十六到五十节。我们读三十六节，从七章三十六节到三十八节，有一位法利赛人请耶稣和他吃饭，耶稣就到法利赛人家里去坐席。那城里有一个女人是个罪人，知道耶稣在法利赛人家里坐席，就拿着圣香膏的玉瓶站在耶稣背后挨着他的脚哭，眼泪湿了耶稣的脚，就用自己 的头发擦干，又用嘴连连亲他的嘴脚把香膏抹上。路加福音七章三十九到四十节，请耶稣的法利赛人看见这事，心里说，这人若是先知，必知道摸他的是谁，是个怎样的女人，乃是个罪人。耶稣对他说，西门，我有句话要对你说。西门说，夫子，请说。四十四到四十七节，于是转过来向着那女人便对西门说，你看见这女人吗？我进了你的家，你没有给我水洗脚，但这女人用眼泪湿了我的脚，用头发擦干。你没有与我亲嘴，但这女人从我进来的时候就不住的用嘴亲我的脚。你没有用油抹我的头，但这女人用香膏抹我的脚。所以我告诉你，她许多的罪都赦免了，因为她的爱多。但那赦免赦免少的，她的爱就少。
You know, so can you see how much Jesus' heart was stirred by this woman?
你看见了吗？就是这个妇人如何就是感动到耶稣。
You know, when I read this passage, right, I always ask myself this question. That was a difficult part for me. When the woman came, she wept, right? There were tears coming down her eyes, okay? Because she was sad about her own life, of her sinfulness, and tears dropped on Jesus' feet. And then she bowed down, and then she began to wipe Jesus' feet with her hand. But you notice that Jesus never reacted. Have you ever thought that? How come? If someone were to touch you, what are you going to do? Right? Jesus never reacted, you know.
每次当我在读这段经文的时候，我都有问我自己这个问题，就是当这个女人，当然了，她进来的时候，她知道她自己是一个罪人，她也为着她自己的那一个生命 而感受到，就是有很多的有很多的感触，而且她因着她自己罪呢，她也是谦卑的，甚至为自己生命而流下眼泪来去圣经上形容到她就是俯下身去摸耶稣的脚之类。可是我在问说，为什么耶稣他当这女人去动他的时候，他没有很大的反应？然后如果是问我们自己，如果就有人这样子动你的话，你难道没有反应的吗？
Okay, of course I cannot read Jesus' mind, I was not thereYou know, but I believe one of the reasons is Jesus was so touched by this woman's gratitude. You know, he was so stirred that it's like, wow, I cannot believe it. Look at what this woman is doing for me.
当然我并没有当时没有在那一边，我也不懂得耶稣真正心里在想些什么。可是呢，很有可能是这样吧，可能就是。耶稣呢？因为看见了这个妇女的那种感谢的心，和她的那种感恩的心呢，而真的就是感动到她来到这个地步，她 他可能可能耶稣在想，哇，我真的不敢相信，竟然会有这样的人这么充满心里充满着感谢感恩。
Okay, Jesus was so stern that when the Pharisees was critical, Jesus challenged the Pharisees. Hey, do you see this woman? Look at her. How grateful and appreciative she is to me.
甚至呢，耶稣也对那一些法利赛人，就是那些批评论断的那些法利赛人，挑战他们说，他说你们难道没有看见到这个妇人的那个感恩的心吗？
You know, so we got to ask ourselves, is our devotion like this woman, that we are so devoted, we are so thankful in our prayers, we are so grateful and my God, appreciative in our prayers, that God's heart is so moved and so stirred by our actions.
有时候我们有没有问我们自己，就是内心里面有没有像这个妇女一样，就是心中就是充满了那种对神的那种感谢和感恩的心呢？
You know, will Jesus up in heaven say to his angels, wow, look at that brother! His entire quiet time, his 30 minutes of prayer is just about thanking me, thanking God for all the great things that God has done.
那么神呢，会不会在天上他看着你的祷告的时候，他就召唤天使来，哎，你来看一看，你看这位弟兄，他几乎他的祷告，他的灵修里面一半以上都在为着感恩的事情来感谢和赞美吗？
Okay, or is it every time you give your phone call to Jesus, right? Ring, ring, he look at his headphone. Oh no, take me.Aiyo, complaining again. Ah, please. Hey, Angel, you answer.
或者是否是说神啊，他在就是收到你的电话的时候呢，看见你的电话，哎，看见那声音在响 ，ring ring 那种的，哎呦，等命来了，整天在那埋怨的，来，哎呀，天使，你来听一听吧。
Right? You know, some people when you call, you look at the name, you already say.Aiyo, why call again another complaint? Abyss.
那就好像我们有时候收到某人的电话的时候，我就哎呦，这个人哈，然后你就觉得说如果是被人有这样子的感觉，就真的不好了。
Okay, or some numbers that come in, right? You know, they come in because they want to ask you to buy something.
或者是有时候收到一些电话，你知道说他就是想要叫你帮忙买东西的那些。
Again, they want you. Hello, I'm John from Citibank. Can I talk to you for a minute? How many times you call? Your colleague's been calling me, you know, the whole day.
然后只是让你说那些电话，就说 Hello, 然后说我叫 John, 然后说我是来自 Citibank, 然后我想要叫你买东西。你知道吗？你说这样的电话，你讲的你不懂多少次哦。你的同事已经打过电话给我。
So, what kind of phone call do you give to God?
那你是打什么样的电话给神啊？
Not that he won't answer your prayers or he doesn't want to listen to your complaint. He does. But is it filled with gratitude or just filled with complaints?
当然了，神并不是说他会只听某一些祷告，其实他全部祷告他都会听。只不过问题是在于我们会给神什么样子的祷告罢了。
Okay, so we got to ask ourselves, what will I do? What will you do as your devotion to God?
所以我们需要问我们自己，我们将会全意的向神做些什么呢？
You know, when we pray, let's have a large portion of our prayer just really praising God and thanking God for what He has done for us.
那我们真的是需要就是花时间去就是改变我们的祷告生命呢，去向神赞美和感谢。
Okay, don't worry that God will not answer your prayers. He will. All you have to do is just say one statement. He already know what you need. You know, but let's fill it with what? Gratefulness as we ask for our request.
不要就是忧虑神会不会应许你的祷告，因为你只要一开口呢，神就其实知道你要祷告些什么了。 所以呢，你应该要做的是多向他感谢和赞美。
Okay, I wrote down what are some possible challenges that stops us from being grateful.
我在这些立了一些啊，可能会拦阻我们向神感谢和赞美的一些事项。
All right, number one, could it be you're too rushed in your prayer? No time to praise God because what? Rush to work. So better put in all my requests, you know, before I have to rush my work.
有时候是是不是因为你太过太过忙和赶时间，然后你讲说时间不够了，赶快先把我的需求先跟神讲一讲先。
Okay, or are we the type of people that are naturally, due to our schemas, ungrateful and negative?
也或者是因着我们本人就是自己的那种性格我们很负面，也就是不感恩的那种。
Okay, or maybe some of us, we struggle with self-centeredness. You know, we just want to be taken care of, rather than what? Serving God.
那我们可能有一些是挣扎，就是自我中心。然后呢我们的希望自己被照顾到，可是我们没有时间去想到神。
Okay, or sometimes we are very prideful and feeling entitled. We feel like, yeah, you know, God needs to answer my prayer.Again, we feel like we deserve it. So, in our heart, we are not grateful to God.
也或者是我们的心里面很骄傲，我们觉得说我们是应得的，然后我们讲说神应该是会祝福我的这样子。
Okay, and if you are entitled or you're proud, you know you will struggle when you don't see God answering your prayers.
如果你常常想着你是应得而且骄傲的话呢，当神不应许你的祷告的时候呢？你就会挣扎了。
Okay, or maybe it's a bad habit. Remember we talk about godly habit?
Yeah.
Alright, you have never learned to have a habit of thankfulness as a person.
还记得吗？我们曾经提到就是属灵的好习惯，但是呢，对我们自己来讲呢，我们却从来没有培养过感谢和感恩的习惯。
Okay, you know, ask yourself in one day, how many times do you say the word?Thank you to people around you.
你曾经有看问过自己一天你可以讲多少次谢谢呢？在你生命里面一天。
Some of us in one week you can count your finger, you know. How many times? One week, one time.
有时候呢，我们甚至呢，就是一个礼拜里面呢，我们可以算得出几次几次啊？我这个礼拜讲了一次，谢谢。
Okay, like what we talk about, it's a bad habit. You gotta break that bad pattern and have some good godly habit of gratefulness and thanksgiving.
这就是我所讲的一些坏习惯。我们应该要改变这些坏习惯。我们应该要去感谢。
Okay, or it is because maybe sometimes we struggle with bitterness, and when you struggle with bitterness, it's very hard to be grateful. So you have to deal with your bitterness in your heart.
也是或者我们内心里面挣扎了很多很多的这些苦毒和埋怨吧。可能你如果是你内心里面充满了这些苦毒和埋怨呢，你需要去改变，直到你可以懂得如何去感谢。
Okay, sometimes we struggle with, well, what to thank God? What to praise God? You know, God is God. How to praise God? I don't know how to praise God.
每次呢，我们都会讲说，我们要怎样感赞美神啊？神他就是伟大的嘛。可是要怎样子真正的去赞美他？我不会。
Again, sometimes thanking God is a bit easier, but praising God is a bit more challenging.
有时候谢谢他还来得比就是去赞美他来得容易。
So I wrote down some areas.Then you can give some areas of thanksgiving and praise.
那我就为大家写下了这一些我们可以感谢或者赞美的事项。
How about devote a big portion of prayer for one day, just about the uniqueness, the specialness, how wonderful the Bible is.
你或者是我，你可不可以花一次的祷告？就是完全就是放中就是焦点放在圣经的独特的圣经是很奇妙的圣经是等等各种各样就是感恩的感谢圣经的事项。
Okay, all write down list down all the different God, all the promises that God has wrote down in the Bible. You know, and just thanking God and praising Him for all the different promises that's given to you in the Word of God.
也或者是你可以写下关于到你对就是神他为你是许下的许多的承诺，你全部都是一的写出来，然后感谢他呢。
Okay, how about this one? Thanking God for the different disciples that are in your life.
也或者是这一个好不好？就是说，你为着你生命的每一个你周围的这个门徒。为他们祷告，就是他是让他们在你的生命里面。
Okay, so in your prayer, you say, I thank God for Xavier. So wonderful. persevering in his trial. Thank God for Xiang Yu. Amazing guy. Again, coming back to get strength with God. Right? I thank God for Daniel. Passionate with his drum. And serving God. Thank God for Derek, who loves to eat. It's a good friend of mine. Okay, and you just thank God for every single members in the church that is a part of your life. And you find you will be even much more closer to them as a person.
虽然我们其实可以为着每个人为着比如说Xavier 啦，翔宇啦，或者是 Daniel， 或者是因为就是像 Derek 这样子，就为了他们每一个人去赞美感谢神。其实你为了他们赞美感谢过后呢，你甚至还能够有种感觉，跟他们的关系上也好像似乎亲近了很多，对不对
？Okay, because so often we only thank God for who ourselves. God, thank you for making me. Amen. Thank you so much for the team. Amen. To widen your prayer.
那时候呢，我们就只懂得为着自己感谢说神，哇，神你创造了我，神啊，谢谢你。但是呢，我们应当就是把我们的祷告能够扩张扩充一点，能够让我们能够把周围也列在里感谢里面。
Okay, even historical event, you know, God has shaped this world.In such a marvelous, situation, right? You live in a world that you feel like, wow, I'm so blessed. I have Samsung handphone. How about thank God for Samsung handphone? God, thank you for making Samsung. Samsung, right? I can do WhatsApp. God, wonderful. Which engineer you create? Wonderful engineer. Why not?Again, God has given us great technology, historical event.
是的，我们也真的是可以为着不同的，就是甚至为着就是历史和所有的这些事情祷告比如说，甚至我们有时候也是可以为着我们自己的神所赐的比如说我们的三星手机而感谢为什么呢？因为神创造了那个工程师，他把这个手机跟他给创造了出来我们也是可以想，就是很多方面去感谢神。
Okay, if you're iPhone fan, then maybe you're not so thankful.
Hey, 如果是 iPhone 的支持者，那么你可能就没这么感恩，是吧
？Okay, and husband, wife, in your prayer every day, thank God for your husband.Thank God for your wife. You know, you find your relationship will grow with you.
甚至是夫妻们我们应该要天天的都向神感谢神赐给的彼此。
Amen. Here are some ideas for next week D group.
这是下个礼拜当我们在 D group 的时候可以问的一些问题。
Okay, so let's talk about, you know, how's our prayer life? Is it more towards thanksgiving and praise?Or is it towards more needs? You know, and how are we going to change? How are you going to change and grow in your prayer life?
这个礼拜我们可以谈说我们的祷告里面我们可以谈我们自己的祷告是大部分是在于就是请求还是感恩然后我们可以谈到我们该如何改进
Now, how about this one? Write 20 things that you are grateful for and then in a group, you share 20 things that you feel blessed by
你或者是在下礼拜里面写下20样事情你能够感谢神的，然后在你的小组里面可以跟大家分享。
Okay, last time we used to challenge one another, write 1,000 things. No, you did it. Of course, I never wrote down 1,000, but it was very challenging. Yeah.
还记得当年呢，啊，曾经有过，就是要写下1000个事项，我们可以感谢神的。虽然啊，没有真正的我自己没有真正做到，但是真的是很挑战。
You know, but I remember writing down the list, the long list. Wow, my heart really changed.
我还记得当我自己真的是有这样做去尝试的时候呢，我的心也因此而改变。
Okay, here's another suggestion. Maybe instead of writing 20 things, you can write a poetry or a psalm, your own psalm. Alright? King Jack psalm. Wow. Or praise and thanksgiving.
Come on. 我们甚至还可以更写。写二十个事项去感谢神，我们甚至可以自己写一首诗，就像大卫王一样，就是你自己的作品，然后但是呢却是感谢神的。
Okay, then you can share your group your little poetry or your psalm of thanksgiving. Okay, or some of us who are more into music, write your own song. Why not? Of thanksgiving and praise.
那甚至不管什么形式都好，我们那些喜欢音乐的就。可以自己去做首歌来去赞美神啊。
Okay, and then at the end of the D group, right? You can close out with prayer together with thanksgiving and praise. Yep.
那之后呢，就是D group完了分享完了过后呢，你可以有一个简短向神感谢和感恩的祷告。
So in closing, let us learn okay in our heart as we pray to have a heart of thanksgiving and praise. Thank you.
所以我们今天学习到这两点，就是如何拥有一个感恩和感谢的祷告。谢谢。
Thank you. Anything announcement?
So one announcement. So that is tomorrow. You we gonna have our.Transport, please arrange earlier. Right, so let's have a quick time. Okay, let's have a quick time. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you.